So he goes down the target line into zone two, hello, and then he puts it down to the ground on the heel line. And then from there on the heel line, it goes outside the ball line. Ball target line with the club head. Heel line with the stick. Outside the ball target line with the stick. Ball target line with the club. This is what I was saying to him as he was swinging, right? He was probably hating me. Stick pointed to the heel line. Outside the ball target line. So these three sticks, even if you're swinging at home and you have that issue, you can fix it with these exaggerations. Hey guys, so I want to let you know real quick about an awesome holiday special we're doing at CogornoGolf.com. We're actually doing over 50% off for the special of our yearly membership. Normally, it costs $69 a month. You can get a whole year, 12 months of CogornoGolf.com, monthly swing evaluations, everything on the site for $395, over 50% off what you would pay for a full year. Now, this isn't gonna last forever. We're only doing this for a limited time from December 15th through January 1st. So we're gonna put a link in the description down below to CogornoGolf.com. I would love for you to check it out. Everything you need to take your game to the next level. This is the lowest price it's ever gonna be. We probably won't ever do this again. I would love to see you there. Check out CogornoGolf.com. Grab this while you still can. We'll put the link down below. Hey guys, Eric here out at the Don Law Golf Academy at the beautiful Osprey Point Golf Club in Boca Raton, Florida. In today's video, we're gonna talk about how to get rid of one of the really the biggest issues in golf, something that I coach all the time out of players, which is having a backswing that gets too flat, leading to a downswing that gets too steep, leading to all kinds of compensations, contact issues, off-center contact, pulls, fades, pull hooks, all kinds of stuff bad coming from this pattern. So I have a little grid here set up, and I'm going to talk you through what I did with a player last week that I was working with in a lesson. And this is a lesson that I give all the time, and it works really good. So I'm going to show you this specific drill. I'll explain how it works in a moment. Now, let's start with just the basic premise of what we're talking about here. Flat to sort of over the top, flat, steep, swing plane stuff. So the issue here that this player had, which comes up all the time, and this is something I'd like you to check to see if you have, is during the backswing, this golfer was getting the club too flat or horizontal. Now, that getting too flat and horizontal during the backswing, this is one of those things where the equal and opposite theory does apply, where it gets steeper than coming down. So if you look at a pattern of how someone moves a club, if someone goes back and the club gets really horizontal early, typically it's gonna get steeper later to try and find center. So horizontal back leads to steep down. Horizontal back, steep down, that'd be bad. What we want to have happen is it stay on plane, or, so on plane meaning the butt of the club, this blue stick and this yellow one is pointed right at the target line, so it's the ball target line. So on plane, right, like perfect on the way back, would be the stick or the butt of the club pointed basically right at that line. That would be like right on plane. So now we know horizontal, or pointed outside of that on the way back is bad. So we want on plane or slightly inside. So if you watch any of our backswing videos we used to do in takeaway backswing, we showed countless examples of the players, the best players in the world, when they get their takeaway and when they get the left arm parallel, that shaft plane is on plane or just inside. This is like Q1000 swings on our 700 plus videos showing those same backswing plane motions. And the reason we want to do that is because when we get on plane, or it's slightly more vertical, it's going to lead to it getting more horizontal down. So if horizontal back leads to steep down, it serves to reason that a little bit more vertical back leads to horizontal down. Now, why do we want horizontal down? Well, some of you know or have seen, you know, the idea of shallowing the club, or the club working down in a more horizontal angle than on the way back. This again, cue the 50 videos, right, of the swing plane of the players we have at left arm parallel, where if you draw that same line down the butt of the club, their club points to that ball target line or slightly outside of it. That allows them to do all the good things with their pivot to get the club back to the ball, which I'll explain more in a future video, how and why that works. That allows them to swing the club from inside. That allows them to produce a lot of speed, very passive release, high distance draw shots, all good things. So if that's what we want to do and your issue is flat to steep, the question is, how do we fix it? The baseline answer here, as for all things golf related, golf swing, you always fix an issue by doing the opposite and exaggerating. doing the opposite and exaggerating. So if we go back and the issue is horizontal, in this case, what's the opposite of horizontal? It would be vertical. So fix the opposite, or fix the issue with the opposite. Okay, so my issue's horizontal. How do I fix that? That means I need to feel vertical. So what I'm saying to you is, if you're too horizontal this way and you make your next swing and you feel as though you're very vertical, so feel the opposite, vertical, and exaggerate, very vertical, then when you actually swing and record it, it'll probably be right on plane. You gotta exaggerate like 10 feet to get like a couple inches. Which brings us, finally, to our station here. Okay, I wanna give you a little background as to why this is important. I wanna talk to you today about live view golf. Now, you guys hear me say all the time that you need feedback when you're practicing. You need to know if you're actually doing what you're trying to do. And the best way to give yourself feedback ultimately is video. And not only is video the best way to give yourself feedback, but being able to see yourself simultaneously as you're doing a movement is the best form of video feedback. It's the best way I've seen to make changes in your swing and be able to correlate the differences between your feels and your reels. Live view is super easy to use and set up. Simply set it up behind or in front of you. You connect it with your iPad or phone, pop that on the ground. You can actually do your practice, see yourself as you're doing it, the best way to expedite your process. I encourage you guys to check out Live View Golf. We'll put a link in the description down below with a coupon code. So our station here, what's the deal? I've got my setup and I've got three sticks on the ground. Now, you can just use golf clubs for this. I've got little alignment rods, you can just use golf sticks. I've got the first stick at the ball target line. So I'm going out towards that little pole down the fairway. This stick is right in line with that, ball target line. The second stick I have right in front of my toe line. Call that toe line. And then this last stick I've got on my heel line. Call that heel line. See how fancy that is? Target line, toe line, heel line, okay? So when I make my backswing, this serves as a reminder, and this is what we did in the lesson, this is how I teach this a lot. I've got another stick here, this one you are gonna need an alignment rod for, that I'm gonna put on the side of the shaft, okay? So it's gonna be on the side of the shaft like so. Feels a little funny when you grip it, but you'll get used to it, because it's gonna serve as a little indicator. Now, what happened to this golfer I was working with is during the backswing, the stick came off the hip immediately, and let's even call this, just for the sake of simplicity, zone one. I bet I'm not gonna get this right as we go, but for now, let's say zone one, zone two, zone three. I saw that core video we did, red, white, and blue, and I was all over it a lot with re-explaining it. Zone one, zone two, zone three. One, two, three, Eric, okay. So when we go back, the golfer I was working with got the stick off the hip, got the club in zone two really early, zone three really early, and even behind zone three back here, we'll call that zone four, like this during the takeaway. And then it was way back here, butt of the club pointed way outside in zone one. Still remember those, one, two, three, four? And then what happened when he came down was he got the opposite. So it went from zone one, look at the yellow stick, zone one, then he went back into zone two, in zone three, the shaft got very steep. He had to stand up, toe shots, issues, etc. So we basically wanted to flip that. So he was out here and then in here. I wanted him to go in here, out there. Okay, he was out there with the stick to in here. I want in here, out there. So the stick for him, watch the stick, points way outside the ball line and then towards my toes. I wanted him to go towards his toes, outside the ball line. He was outside ball line, towards toes. I wanted towards toes, outside ball line. That basically was like the net end of the lesson. So when we made a backswing, I put the stick on the side, it was on his hip. We got to parallel. Now he felt like the club head would stay pointed down this ball target line until his hands got about to his thigh. And then from there, I wanted his club head from his point of view to stay in zone two, between these two, until it was parallel to the ground, which to him felt a little more outside. Of course it is. This can ride down your leg a little. Then from there, to exaggerate, I wanted this stick to point towards this heel line. And the reason I want the heel line and not the toe line is it also gave him some added depth. He had to bring his hands in. Here's my hands pointed at my toe line, very vertical shaft. If I go my heel line, I've got to pull the hands more in. So I want a depth here for him. So he goes down the target line into zone two, hello, and then he puts it down to the ground on the heel line. And then from there on the heel line, it goes outside the ball line. ball target line with the club head, heel line with the stick, outside the ball target line with the stick, ball target line with the club. This is what I was saying to him as he was swinging, right? He was probably hating me. Stick pointed to the heel line, outside the ball target line. So these three sticks, even if you're swinging at home and you have that issue, you can fix it with these exaggerations. Now, what I had him do is we did a couple like that. We recorded it from down the line. This is what you should do until it looked like how we wanted with no ball. And of course, he felt like he was in a huge loop, right? I mean, he felt like he was going like this, huge loop. And we looked at it on video and it looked like Adam Scott. It looked like whoever, right up and down, a perfect plane line, because you have to exaggerate the opposite. Then we took the stick out right after a while, started hitting some shots. He wasn't doing it enough. Put it back in, exaggerate, rinse and repeat until we got close. And once he was doing these reps, I wanted him to then get into a rhythm. So he'd kind of start with the club forward, stick in, keep the club head in zone two, outside the hands, hinge it on the heel line, outside ball line, let it swing through. Just to kind of get into a flow. And we just started to add a little bit of speed. Of course, he's feeling this big loop because he needs to exaggerate the opposite. And once I liked how that looked, right, we probably did 20 reps of that. We took that stick out, say, hey, let's replicate the same feels. Start to get a little bit of flow. Again, I'm purposely trying to get him to loop it the other way because he's this way. So when he feels this big Jim Furyk loop and we record it, it goes up and down like the same plane line. So we did that, got a little flow going, letting the club head start forward to set things up. And then we came in, we did an 8-iron, right? So I put the ball down. We did the same feels. I said, feel it going in zone two, heel, boom, we had it. It all felt good. We took our setup position. And guess what happened? He didn't do it enough, okay? He didn't exaggerate enough. And that's very common. And I tell that part of the story here for a reason. Because when we see all these good swings, these perfect swings, I think someone thinks something and just does it perfect right off the bat. If you gotta make a change here, like he did it maybe 20% of what I wanted. And we did like 60 practice swings, so it wasn't just the first time. That's okay, right? Now, what did we do? I put the stick back in, over-exaggerated more to the point where he was like, holy cow. And that got to about 50. I remember we were in the lesson going, I was like, dude, point the butt of the club like behind your heel. It felt stupid. But of course I showed him on video and then it looked perfect. And then we got to 50. And by the end of 2 hours, we're probably at like 80%. Okay, 80% of it. So just understand this will work. If you do it on your first swing and it doesn't work, that's okay. It's gonna take a little time. But I think this is so easy to do regardless of your practice environment. Ball target line, toe line, heel line. If you're looking for that pattern, put the stick on just to see it, but go club head down the target line, stay it in zone two till parallel, on or behind the heel line so you get depth, outside of it, and then start to get a little flow. That's part two, start to let it flow a little bit, and then put the ball in gradually, do the same thing. And if it's not as exaggerated, that felt good. If it's not as exaggerated when you put the camera on, then just keep exaggerating it. It should feel like you're getting some effortless power, effortless speed. The ball's coming off the face better when you're doing this compared to normal. So I like this station. That's fixing flat to steep. If you guys have any questions, always leave a comment down below. Hey guys, thanks for watching today's video. If you guys liked the video, do us a favor. It really helps us out. If you click that little gray like button below this video, go ahead and click that. That really helps us. Click that red subscribe button. All these things really help us with YouTube, get our videos out to more people. Be very thankful. Would really support our channel. If you guys did like this video, we're gonna put another card on the screen to a similar YouTube style video. Go ahead and click that and watch that. If you wanna work with me, I would love to work with you. We'll put a logo on the screen to cogornogolf.com. You can click that, it'll take you right there. Thank you guys for watching.